So basically, I deleted my video before even uploading it. So I'm going to try and kind of hit the points that I made in my video really quickly. I hit on the price of binders, and I've always gone about the price of binders being very expensive. If you're not in a financial state to be able to afford a binder, you're pretty much screwed, to be honest, because they are really good, and honestly, I can't imagine my life without my binder. It completes me. I'm not really going to hit that too much because I always rant about the price of rep binders. If you go on my personal YouTube channel, there's about 7 videos on there of me just ranting about how fucking expensive they are. But I actually want to hit on society. In my last video, I basically spoke about my nephew. Well, in the video that I deleted, I spoke about my nephew basically saying that he didn't think that I was a man. He thought I was a boy, like a little boy, because I didn't have a deep voice or facial hair or anything like that. And it, you know, he came up to me and he said, "No, how old are you?" And I said, "I'm 20. And he said, "Oh, I thought you were like a boy." And I said, "Okay." And he said, "Well, you don't have any hair on your face, or you don't have a deep voice like daddy, so you must be a little boy." And I was like, "Nah." I mean, he's just a child, but basically my point behind that is that society from birth have kind of been brought up to expect these things when you do, you know, mature and all this stuff. The same as if you're a girl and you have small breasts, then people think that you may be younger than you are, etc, etc. Okay, so society's, I'm not going to hit on society's interpretation of transgender. I went to Pride a couple weeks back. That's why I didn't make a video that week. And I was in the parade with Transgender Manchester. I will post videos, I will post pictures on Tumblr for those who are interested. And I will also hit my full, the videos that I have missed, the toilets and the Pride. I will be making a blog and typing that out and posting it on Tumblr. Okay, so basically, Pride came and we were walking around, blah, 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 and there was kind of a 50-50 split between trans guys and trans women. And the trans women were very aggressive, they had a lot to say, and they took the parade as a time to shout about the things they had to say. Now, personally, I think they went around it the wrong way, because they are making society perceive us in a really negative way, because they're walking around shouting and swearing and completely giving abuse. You know, there's children around at the end of the day. People bring their families out to see the parade because it's so, like, colourful and fabulous. Personally, I didn't really like that. I didn't really like that they did that. Like, there was no need to go around swearing and cursing and all that bollocks. So I just, when they did that, I just put my head down because I didn't want to be associated with them. I was completely ashamed to be there with them while they were behaving that way. I understand that society has thrown some curveballs in the transgender community, you know, called us names, etc, etc. But at the end of the day, you know, society is changing slowly but surely, and being gay, transgender, lesbian, bisexual, queer, whatever you want to be, it's more acceptable nowadays. It's more, you know, friendly to the outside world, you know, to the point that, you know, one day you can walk down the street holding, you know, your boyfriend's hand or your girlfriend's hand, and you can be the same gender, and, you know, no one will even second glance it. You know, it'll just be a regular thing, you know. Back in the day, you know, people used to look at black people weird and shame us and all that bollocks. But, you know, times change and people change, and, you know, I understand they might have had some shit, but at the end of the day, you know, the world isn't like that anymore. So I didn't really like that, to be honest. And I think if you are representing a certain group or a certain way, you know, a job or a family or anything, if you're representing something, you want to represent it so it reflects well on the rest of the people. And personally, I didn't think that reflected well on the rest of the people, you know. I was ashamed to be seen with them, and that's me, you know what I mean? But society is changing slowly but surely, and, you know, It is hard. At the moment, I am. I started a new job a couple of weeks back, and I am going stealth with this new job. I've not told anyone that I'm trying it. There's a guy that knew me back in high school, and he keeps asking me about, like, there's someone in high school that looks exactly like you, and her name was Kay or something, and you have similar names. Is that your sister? And I'm like, no, I don't have a clue about. And I don't really want to open myself up to that at the moment because I'm so new to the company. I don't want to be opened up to all the questions and, you know, the second glances and stuff like that. So for the time being, I'm just going to keep it to myself. But, you know, at the end of the day, I've not had any problem. You know, everyone treats me just like one of the guys. You know, I get along with all the girls in the class and all the girls, my training group and all the guys, and I could be going back onto the floor of the company. But, you know, it's easy for me because I do pass quite well among society. For other people that don't, I do feel for them. I do feel bad for them. In the video that I deleted, I also touched on grandparents. As I mentioned in my other videos, I love my grandparents dearly, but their society and my society are two completely different things, and they come from a very, how can I say this? I got a square society, you know, they don't really like outsiders or anything weird and stuff like that. And my grandparents have kind of tried to edge towards my society to match to my lifestyle. Whereas my society, my life, my friends, you know, all that, they're very open, we talk about everything. We, you know, we're all there for each other, etc, etc. And we don't really give a shit about, you know, what you are, who you are, how you represent. We don't really give a fuck. As long as you're a good person, it doesn't really matter. You know, it's what's on the inside that counts, not the external bullshit. I mean, I can't believe I deleted my last video. I'm so pissed off right now. It's just this fucking stupid iMovie app. Ridiculous. But yeah, I am sorry for missing all the videos, and, you know, this group is all about the topic that we're talking about today. It's all about being being seen as an outcast of society, you know, being a person of colour and being transgender. You know, you're automatically two out, you're in two categories of outcast from society. But like I said before, society's changing, you know, the world is evolving and people's opinions and shit aren't solid as used to be. So I honestly think that it's good anyway. But I do thank all the viewers, all the subscribers, all the likes, all the shares, because at the end of the day, the message that we're trying to get over is, you know, that society is bending for us. This is Your Mr. Thursday, and this is Transpoc. Can you make a nigga smile? Won't you satisfy me? Man, I'm the man. Hey, hey, hey.